whether they were joiners or whatever they were, was always God's desire that his people would take his word to the Gentiles. And by Gentiles, I mean to people who haven't heard. It was always his desire. Israel goofed up. They goofed up big time. They didn't take the word to people who hadn't heard. They thought it was theirs to keep. I love my time alone with God. I love the blessings he gives to me and my own. I'm so happy and so content with the life God has given me in us, and that we're insiders. No. He's saying, God's heart is always, look at Isaiah 52. It's always been that the word get out to those who haven't heard. That has always been God's desire. Folks, could it be said of you? Could it be said of me? Could it be said of us? Whether we're evangelists or missionaries, whether we have that spiritual gene, or whether we're shepherds or friends or family members, could it be said of us that our ambition is to take the gospel to those who haven't heard, to those for whom it hasn't sunk in, to those who were in this, like my friend said, well, everybody's a Christian. This is a Christian nation. Could it be said that we all have this ambition, this passion, this goal, this aim, to take the gospel to people who haven't heard? Look at your questions. Just quickly, down at your questions on the back of it. If you were to only look at, only spend the bulk of your time thinking about the two questions, the larger, the three-line statement. Paul said that his ambition was to take the gospel, down toward the bottom. Paul said it was his ambition to take the gospel where Christ was not known. How does this ambition relate to your priorities? How do you just determine who you're going to spend time with and how you're going to spend time with them? How does it relate to your priorities? That ambition. Where are those places where Christ is not known, in your experience? Where are those places? In other words, are you comfortable just being with Christians, or do you just love being out there with non-Christians? Not because it's party time! No, but because you just really want to take the gospel where Christ is not known. And then, where would you personally like to take the gospel? So what's it look like? Just real quickly, what does it look like when, and what kind of people have it as their ambition to take the gospel where Christ is not known? Let me put it before you, folks. It's these kind of people who have that ambition. People who join clubs, join organizations, join things going on in the community because they want to take the gospel where Christ is not known. And you might say, you could bounce back to me and say, well, Pastor, I thought you wanted us to be in church all the time. Well, I want you to be here. I think you ought to be here every week. Yeah. I think everybody here ought to be in a growth group. I really think so. I hope you will, if you haven't been in a growth group, or if you're not in one now, get in one. But please, people who are joiners, want to get out there and mix it up with our community and take the gospel where Christ is not known. It's people who recognize the reason why they live in their neighborhoods. They're there. And because they want to take the gospel where Christ is not known. And they're not just excited to say, well, I sure like our neighborhood. Everybody in our neighborhood is Christian. Everybody. Every night we get together and hold hands, sing kumbaya, you know. But they love the fact that there's some really, the people in their neighborhood that play loud, stinky music that you don't like. Because I'd love to take the gospel where Christ is not known. It's people who just are passionate about the fact that they know that they've got family members, and they're looking around to our family. Does everybody know Christ? We want to take the gospel to people who don't know Christ. People who are excited about the fact that they're parents. They are parents, and they have exposure to other parents or other couples that don't know Christ, and they just take those relationships with other kids and the sports that they're involved in and the extra things that their kids are involved in. They look at those opportunities to be with those families and those couples who don't know Christ. And if you're a single person, you just love mixing it up with other singles who don't know Christ. You love it because it's your ambition to take the gospel where Christ is not known. It's bosses, like a friend of mine who works with them, with Christian CEOs. That's his whole ministry, is a ministry to Christian CEOs. And he gets these guys together every week for this reason. And if you're a leader of a business or you're a supervisor, take the clue from my friend Ken, who gets these CEOs together, and he says, the reason why we have this company is not simply to make a huge profit and stuff our pockets, but because we've got a bunch of people who work for us, lots of people, and we want to serve them faithfully, and we want to help them succeed, but we also want to present Christ to them. And they look at ways that their business can have a ministry, a real, sincere, wonderful ministry to the people that work for them. I know someone very dear to me who has a huge passion for friends who don't know Christ. And will drop any and everything to share Christ or to be the next link in the relationship, to offer that person as an offering to God, now acceptable, having turned the life to Him. What's your ambition? What's our ambition? It doesn't have to be that we will just go to Mongolia. It doesn't have to be, while that's wonderful, it doesn't have to be that we will go into the inner city or into the slum. It's the ambition. It's that person with the ambition beating in our soul to share Christ with the people around us, or to insert ourselves into relationships so that Christ will be known. May that be our ambition. Amen? Let's pray. Father, thank you so much for the privilege of opening your word and catching a bit of Paul's ambition. Thanks for using him and countless people who see the place that you have for them in their family, in their neighborhoods, in the community, or in distant parts of the world, having an ambition to take Christ where he is not known. I pray, Father, that you would, while you make us comfortable and supported among family and friends that love you, I pray that we would also be willing to be uncomfortable and placed in those places that maybe at one time had disgusted us, but now give us a place where we can share Christ with people. So, Father, I pray that we would be people with ambition for the sake of the gospel. In Christ's name I pray, amen. Would you please make sure you take your information forms and fill those out and pass them to the center aisle, and they'll be picked up as we sing a closing song.